The unexpected clash, how one program can affect another. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's the question. I experienced Macrium Reflect taking a long time to perform its backup. I discovered that if I end task OneDrive sync engine in Task Manager, it reduced runtimes from hours to minutes. Stuff like this happens. And while I want to be very clear, this video is not about the combination of Macrium Reflect and OneDrive. Honestly, I think that's all been resolved. But it is about understanding how two seemingly unrelated programs can sometimes affect one another. Now, I want to be clear, it shouldn't matter. In this scenario, OneDrive and Reflect should work happily together. They shouldn't really that negatively impact one another. As of course, there'll be some impact because you have two programs running on the system instead of one, and they might be competing for some resources like the hard disk. But in general, hours to minutes kinds of things are a problem that simply shouldn't happen. Now, sometimes it's obvious, right? You've got a program running, you start another program, and all of a sudden that first program starts to misbehave or behave poorly. The bottom line is that it's pretty clear, right? These two programs don't like each other for whatever reason. It's not at all uncommon. In fact, the best example I can give you is the advice that we often give that says, it's fine to have two anti-malware tools installed on your machine at the same time, but it is not okay to have them both running at the same time. Basically, quote unquote, results are unpredictable. You can get false positives, you can miss things, you can have crashes, you can have all sorts of problems. But that's an example of two programs that we know are likely to interact with one another in a bad way. The problem here, of course, is that we don't expect these programs to be interacting with each other pretty much in any way. Now, if it weren't for the massive amount of time, though again, hours to minutes is a huge change, and the fact that Reflect is using technologies designed to specifically avoid these kinds of problems, we could make the case that says, hey, you know, they're both accessing the disk at the same time. Maybe files are changing that Macrium just sort of can't keep up with. I mean, there's any number of different things that you could talk about in terms of, well, maybe it's this, maybe it's that. We don't know. And like I said, it shouldn't happen, but sometimes it does. And the fact that it can happen is actually an important thing to remember when you're diagnosing a problem. If you've got a program that is misbehaving in some way, think about what else is going on your system. What else is running? What other kinds of services or programs do you have going on, either that you've run or that are running in the background, that maybe could impact what it is you're seeing with whatever program you're having a problem with. Again, I can't give you any specifics because this is one of those very nebulous concepts. One program can affect another. That's the only thing I really want you to walk away with, is understanding that that can happen. And when that happens, really your only diagnostic tool is to basically start doing what this questioner did. He turned off OneDrive, and as a result, Macrium Reflect picked up. So we now know that there's an interaction between them. How he decided to do OneDrive? I don't know. It's probably part of a pretty reasonable diagnostic process. And it's that kind of a process that you're probably going to have to look into when you experience these kind of problems. I have to reiterate, this video is not about an interaction between Macrium Reflect and OneDrive. My understanding is that there isn't one. Things are working. Things should be working. But the fact is, the huge takeaway here is simply understanding that sometimes unrelated programs can interfere with one another. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/30468. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.